Welcome to our lecture online. Now let's do an example of a very familiar transition, the transition from n equals 3 down to n equals 2, which is part of what we call the Balmer series. That particular transition for an electron in the hydrogen atom will release a photon or emit a photon that has a frequency or a wavelength that puts it right in the area of visible light. Again, the principle is the same. We need to calculate the energy difference between the two levels, between n equals 3 and n equals 2 level. That energy difference will equal the energy of the photon being released. And if you realize that the energy of the levels can be calculated like this, and the energy of the photon can be calculated like this, then we can say the wavelength of the photon is equal to h times c, Planck's constant times the speed of light, divided by the energy of the photon. Of course, the energy of the photon being equal to the energy difference between the two levels. So let's first calculate the energy of the two levels. So energy of the third level is equal to 1 over 3 squared times a minus 13.6 electron volts, which makes it equal to 1.51 electron volts with a minus in front, of course, because it's lower than 0 electron volts. It's a negative. It's a, like a potential well. And E sub 2 is equal to 1 over 4. 4 or 1 over 2 squared times a minus 13.6 electron volts, which is equal to a minus 3.4 electron volts. So the difference in the energy, and of course we want to find the magnitude of that difference, that would be E2 minus E3 is equal to the magnitude of, if I make them positive values, 3.4 electron volts minus 1.51 electron volts, which is equal to, that would be 1.89 electron volts. So that's the energy difference between the two levels, not exactly, but close enough. And that then becomes equal to the energy of the photon. So the energy of the photon released is equal to the difference in the energy between the two levels, is equal to 1.89 electron volts. Now let's plug that into our equation right here to find the wavelength of the photon. So lambda is equal to hc over e of the photon, which in this case is 6.626 times 10 to the minus 34, 3 times 10 to the 8, and that would be 1.89 electron volts. Multiply that times the conversion from electron volts to joules, 1.6 times 10 to the minus 19 joules per electron volt. Again, we're not going to get the exact value because we have some round-off errors, but at least it shows you how to do it correctly. All right, 6.626 e to the... The result, 657.3. However, I know that the exact value should have been, without the round-off error, of 56.3 nanometers, which is 656.3 times 10 to the minus 9 meters. And of course, that's a wavelength that's associated with red light. And when you look at hydrogen gas and there are electron transitions, we will indeed see the red color of the jumps from the electrons that go from the third level down to the second level. So this is how we calculate the energy difference first, and then associate that energy difference with the energy of the photon, which then gives us the wavelength of the photon. And that's how it's done using method 2.